Hi everyone, welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at QR codes and what we can do with QR codes inside of Scriptcase. My name is Nate Carpenter. I'm going to be teaching this tutorial. I hope this is helpful for you. Let's get started. So here we are in our Scriptcase development environment, and we're going to use QR codes in two ways, and these are the two ways that Scriptcase supports QR codes, and that's in a grid and then in a PDF report application. So let's get started with a grid application. So I'm going to go up here to new application right in this top menu. We click that and it will load here. And we're going to create a grid application. I'm going to use our default connection here. We're going to select our table here. We're going to select the products table. This is from the samples project that comes with your Scriptcase installation. And I'm going to select just a few fields. I'm really only interested in the product ID, product name, and unit price. So we're going to select those three fields. And we're going to call this grid products demo and click create. Okay, so I've got a basic grid created. Let's go ahead and run this and see what this looks like. So this is just a basic grid, displays three fields, nothing fancy, but we're going to add some stuff to it. So let's go back. Let's change it so it only displays one record at a time. That'll make it look a little bit nicer for reading QR codes. So we're going to go to the grid modules here on this left menu, which is the initial screen that loads when you click on the grid. We're going to select the grid module. And we need to display just one line per page. So that's just going to display one line per page. And then we're going to put it in slide orientation. We can ignore that message for right now, since we do have a width set. And we can put it in slide orientation there, and that will kind of put it viewing across kind of. So let me show you what that's going to look like. So we're going to run that. Okay, so it's kind of viewing across, just one record at a time, across and up and down here. So we've got our fields up and down, and then they go all the way across the screen here. So that looks decent. It's got a better setup here, review one at a time. So let's add our QR codes. So to do that, we need to go to the fields over here, and we're going to add a new field, just one for right now. And the type needs to be the QR code type. This is already set up with Scriptcase, so we really don't have to worry about a whole lot. And I'm going to put the product ID in this QR code. So I'm going to call it QR prod ID and put the label as product ID, and then we can click create. And so here's some settings. We can give it a margin. We can give it some error correction, the image size, which we're going to mess with in a little bit. But for now, let's now assign a value to the prod ID QR code. So we want to assign the product ID value to this field. So we need to do that in the events with some PHP code. So we're going to go to events here on this left menu and the on record event. So this is when each record loads. And we're going to take the QR prod ID field. And we're going to set that equal to the product ID here, like so. And of course we know that these curly braces means that it's accessing the value in the field on screen. So that'll get that product ID value and put it in there. And then Scriptcase handles converting it into a QR code for us, so we don't have to worry about that. So that makes things a lot easier. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Okay, so now we have our product ID QR right here, but that's a little small to use. So we're going to make it a little bit bigger so it's a little bit easier to read. So let's go over here to the QR prod ID field. And this is a setting we saw earlier. Let's make it 84 by 84. And let's give it a little bit bigger margin too, so it'll kind of space it out a little bit and see what that looks like. Okay, now we've got a bigger image and it's a little bit spaced out, so that makes it nice and clean. So now let's go ahead and read this and see what it looks like. So I've got here a mirror of my phone screen here, right here on the left, and I've got my camera app open already. So all I need to do is just scan this QR code with the camera app, and it should recognize the product ID. So it should give me a value of 1. So let's go ahead and give this a try. So I'm going to do it there. And as you can see, right here, it says it contains 1. So that's pretty good. It displayed the value that was assigned to that QR code. So let's go back and let's make this a little more built out. So that's the product ID. That's somewhat useful, but maybe we want to add some more info in, such as our other 3 fields. So let's go here and create another QR code field. So new field again, creating a new field. It's going to be a QR code just like before. And we're going to call this one prod, keep the same naming scheme. So QR prod info, like so. Call it product info and click create on that one. Okay, so that's created. Let's go ahead and give it the same settings as the other one. So make it 84 by 84 and give it a margin of 4. And then let's go to on record. We'll save the changes. And now let's assign a value to that field. So we've already got this. I'm going to go ahead and copy this and then edit it like so. So we're now assigning the QR prod info field to some info. So we're going to keep the product ID and we're just going to do a comma delimited list. So we're going to do some quotes. We're going to concatenate this and then we're going to add the product name. Put a comma in between again, concatenate it together, and with the unit price. So that gives us 3 pieces of data. And of course, this could be any bits of data from the database. But then once you get this string out, then perhaps you could have something on your phone or something that could read a comma separated list here. So this is almost like a CSV that is being read by the QR code. So that could be useful for a few applications. So we've got the QR code field created. And we've got it assigned to a value here. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. We should have 2 QR codes now. And that we do. We have a product info field and our product ID. So let's go ahead and read this one and see what it says. Okay, so we have both of our QR codes here. We have our product ID one and our product info one. So let's go ahead and scan this with my phone's camera. So let's bring that up here. Here it is. And let's go ahead and try and scan this. So try to get it centered. And there we go. We see our contents, our product ID, 1, our product name, chai, and then the unit price, 2178. So that works. So now let's take this to another level and do it with a URL. So we're back in our browser. So we're back in our Scriptcase development environment, and we need to add another QR field to make a URL that can be clicked on when scanned with the QR. So we're going to add a new field, 1 new field, QR type, of course. This is going to be just like the other ones. I'm going to name it QR URL and have the label be URL. Click create. And let's give it the same settings as the others. So 84 by 84 dimensions and a margin of 4. That should set up our QR field. And now let's set a value to this. So this is going to be a URL that can be clicked. So we're going to assign to that QR URL field a URL. So we're not assigning it to another field this time. We're assigning it to a value, a string. I'm going to assign it to my URL here. This is my website. And so when this is scanned, it should pop up a URL and that can be clicked on by the user. And it should direct them to my website, anycarpenter.com. So before we give this a try, I'm going to go ahead and take the other QRs off the screen just so it's easier for my camera to pick it up. So I'm just going to go up to edit fields here and drag these down to the fields not shown. That way it's easier for the camera to distinguish which QR we want it to read. So let's go ahead and run this and give it a try. All right, so we've got the URL QR code right here. Let's see if this works. So let's pull up my phone. There it is, and let's try and scan this thing. It should pull up my URL that I put in there. There it is. Let's click on that. It should take me to my website. And here we go. Here's my website. So it works. Now let's go back and add another layer. So another use for QR codes is to insert an email address into the QR code that can be read and clicked on to start an email. So let's go back to our Scriptcase development environment. Okay, so I've got the email address in. Now we need to make it a mail to link like you would put on HTML on a website. So for that, you just need the mail to with a colon, and that'll open it right up as an email link, and your phone should know how to do that. So let's run this and see what it looks like. Okay, there's our email QR, and let's scan it on our phone and see what happens. Let me pull the phone up. There it is. And let's go ahead and scan this with the camera. Okay, and it sees it as anycarpenter@gmail.com. Let's click on that. And it asks which app we want to pop it up in. Your phone may or may not do this. Click on Gmail. Let's do it just once for now. Okay, and so it's sending an email to anycarpenter@gmail.com. It's covering it up there. There it is. Because my Gmail app already knows who that is. Okay, so this is how we can use QR codes and grids. And of course, there's a lot more ways that you could implement it. But these are just a few. Putting some product info in, either the product ID, or you could concatenate some product info together, like we did. You could also add the URL in the QR code or the email in the QR code with a mail to link and have it open right up in the user's email app. So that gives us a lot of functionality as developers without a lot of code. We just had to assign values and Scriptcase handle generating the QR codes and everything. So that's really nice and convenient. Now let's look at doing this in a PDF application. So it's going to be very similar, and we're going to use the same setup here, but we're going to put it in a PDF. So let's go back to our Scriptcase. So we're going to go to New Application up here. Wait for that to load. And then PDF Report right here. We're going to choose the same products table. And then the same set of fields, so the product ID, the product name, and the unit price. So there's our set of fields. We're going to call this PDF report underscore products underscore demo. Follow the same naming scheme as before. And then let's click create. Give this just a second to load here. Okay, looks like we're all loaded up. And if we go over here to layout PDF, we'll see kind of a mock-up of what our PDF is going to look like. So this is just a very basic PDF. We just have these three fields. They're going to be in these three locations here. And that's just where everything is. It'll do one item per page. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. So this will generate a PDF for us. And if you've ever had to create a PDF report without the help of something like Scriptcase, it really is a lot of work. So Scriptcase is automating a lot of this for us. And as you can see here, we have our three fields and we can put our QR code over here. But as you can see, it's only putting one record per page. So that seems kind of a waste since we're only putting a few here. So we're going to divide this page up into four horizontal columns. So let's go back to Scriptcase. And we're going to go over here. And we want to adjust our columns. So we're going to do four columns. We want the width of the columns to be the full width of the PDF. So that's 279 millimeters. And then the column height is going to be the width of the PDF divided by four, which is 54. So So let's run that. And as you can see here, we've got four columns with just a little bit of space at the bottom. So that makes it look much better, so we can add multiple records on each page. Now let's add a QR code. So this is going to be very similar to a grid. We're going to go over to Fields, New Field, add one new field. It's going to be our QR code field. We're going to put in it the product ID. So we're going to call it QR prod ID, just like on the other one. And this could be, of course, any data that we want to put into it. And let's make it a 84 by 84. Let's not give it a margin, because the PDF will probably take care of that. Let's go ahead and save that. And now we need to go to events, and then the on record event, and assign a value to it. So here we can just copy the same code that we used in the grid and put it in the PDF. Since we already have it built, we already know it works. We're assigning the QR prod ID field to the product ID field. So let's go ahead and run this, and we should see QR codes on our PDF. Okay, so there they are, but they don't look very pretty because we didn't assign them to a good location on the PDF. So let's go back now and decide where we want them to be put. So we see it's putting it up there already. So it automatically added that cell to the PDF when we created the field. Let's put it over here to the left. Give it a nice little bit of space. Let's line it up the product ID. So the Y position of that is 10. So let's make sure this Y position is 10 as well. That way the top of the QR code will line up with the top of the product ID. Now let's go ahead and run this and see if it looks better. Okay, so here we have a pretty nice looking basic PDF. It displays some product info here, and then a QR code. So that could be scanned on our phone, and we could have an application that then went and saved that information someplace if we needed to. So that provides a lot of functionality to put those QR codes in PDFs where they can be scanned. So those are some different uses of QR codes and the tools that Scriptcase provides for you to develop with them. As you can see, it automates a lot of the process for us. We're really just adjusting some settings and then assigning some values. That's really all we have to worry about as Scriptcase developers with QR codes. We don't have to worry about messing with a library that generates QR codes or writing some code to do it ourselves. It's quite simple. So I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. I hope you can find some good uses for QR codes in your own projects. I'll see you in the next tutorial.